This video showcases use of the DataRobot platform to deliver end-to-end generative AI solutions. The end-to-end part is critical because the solution doesn't deliver any business value until it's fully up and running with end users. Up to that point, it's just an expensive R&D project that could be another statistic of GenAI applications that failed to reach production. In this video, you'll see a collection of DataRobot solution accelerators. Understand how we help customers build with confidence and control costs with guard models, and then see five solution examples that emphasize specific capabilities. Generative AI solutions range from simple to complex, and we offer solution accelerators to match. Whether you're just getting started with a first chatbot for employee usage, or want generative AI to write all your personalized customer communications, you'll find a starter among this growing list. The GenAI accelerators use the powerful DataRobot API to deliver final solutions even faster. They're all available as .ipynb files for direct import into DataRobot or any other data science notebook of your choice. Here in the console, you're seeing several deployments whose sole purpose is to act as a guard or a sidecar to other generative models. DataRobot's able to help you plan and design your generative AI applications with appropriate guardrails. We teach you how to think about various guard models to detect prompt injections and toxicity, to prevent personal data leaks, especially PII or PHI, and to control costs. We provide you with global models in the model registry that you can use off the shelf for these purposes. We also teach you how to develop your own guards and integrate them into applications. Now, onto the examples. I've selected this example because it's one that you can replicate with a DataRobot free trial. It's a web application that uses a RAG framework to answer user questions about movies. As I type new questions into the box, you're seeing two generative models working together. We call the first one a guard model. Its job is to decide if the user input is in scope or out of scope. If it's in scope, the second model then answers the question. This is one way that DataRobot helps you avoid runaway LLM costs and retain operational control. The metrics for both underlying models are in the table on the right. They include a count of total requests, total prompts rejected, cumulative cost, and an estimated cost savings from having the guard model turn away out-of-scope requests. In split-screen mode, you can see the monitoring happening in real time. The web app is in the left pane, and the DataRobot console is in the right pane. You're going to see me input two new questions in the pane on the left. Then I'll refresh the metrics to confirm that they match with the DataRobot console on the right. We'll see 48 total prediction requests, of which 20 prompts were rejected. I hope you'll agree that everything checks out. Going one step further, on the Data Export tab for the guard model, I can access the full text of all the questions that have been submitted. You'll see the most recent question about world records for the 100-meter dash at the end of the table, and correctly marked as out of scope. Let's explore other selected examples. The jitterbot in Slack is included to emphasize integration with familiar front ends. The MedPalm model is included to emphasize that you have the choice to use specialty LLMs. The DocsBot example is included to emphasize human feedback loops and LLM fine-tuning. And the customer emails example is included to emphasize combining generative and predictive AI in one solution. Now I'm inside DataRobot's Slack instance to show a knowledge worker tool we call Jitterbot, which stands for just-in-time retrieval. Unlike the movie example, which builds the vector database in advance, here we build the vector database on the fly based on the PDF that the user provides. It's incredibly helpful for knowledge workers that work with large documents, and it's incredibly convenient that they don't need to leave the familiar interface that they prefer. Here, you see the monitoring metrics for employee usage of the Jitterbot, so you can track its volume relative to its cost and its immense value. This is a demonstration we built combining predictive and generative AI using Google's powerful MedPalm model. It reads a patient's medical history and offers a quick summary. But what if you're a healthcare organization that runs on Azure or AWS? As a DataRobot customer, you can select a purpose-built specialty LLM such as MedPalm and operate and observe it alongside all your other use cases that might be using LLMs from other providers. Here, you're seeing a preview of our Docs Assistant integrated with our documentation. Let me ask it a question. It provides a very nice generated response, and it provides citations with links. Underneath all the output is the opportunity for the user to provide feedback. I'll mark this answer as correct. Now we're in the console for the deployment that's monitoring that external assistant. I'm able to request the prediction data and the actual data. Not every user will provide a response, but the ones that do are saved to a database. This human feedback can then be used to fine-tune the LLM providing the solution. Here you're seeing a list of applications hosted within DataRobot. The Next Best Offer application nicely showcases how you can combine predictive and generative models to deliver a solution not possible with either alone. Imagine a predictive model that predicts the next best offer for each customer once per month, using the customer's most recent activities. Typically, all customers for whom upsell A is the best offer would get the same email communication. But what if each email could be different? In addition to offering the predicted upsell, the email could be personalized for length, tone, and inclusion of details from their customer record. The demonstration you're seeing here uses a predictive model to predict what's the next best offer for each customer, and then a generative model to actually write an email just for them. Additionally, it offers reasons why. So if the customer calls in, the support agent will have ready access to those explanations. In this demonstration, we're doing them one at a time, but the typical process would be to do a batch of emails, say once per month, and integrate this with CRM and marketing automation systems. To recap, you just saw a variety of generative AI solution accelerators that can be directly imported into DataRobot notebooks. You saw multiple guard models in active use, and you saw five examples that emphasize DataRobot's flexibility and extensibility in the generative AI space.